you're planning on visiting Carowinds sometime soon, then you're about to learn some great tips and recommendations on how to have the best day at this park where the Carolinas come together. Carowinds is a special place, and I am blessed that I've been able to call it my home park now since 2014. And living just 10 minutes away definitely has its perks. Near the end of the video, I will share a very crucial Ferry 325 tip with you that'll make your riding experience the best, as I will share with you Ferry's magic seat, the seat that will change everything. I am also going to share with you the best seats and rows to ride on most of the major coasters at Carowinds, so you don't want to miss that. Now, the most important question you need to ask yourself before visiting Carowinds is, should I ride the Vortex? Next question. Oh, and for the record, the answer is no. Don't do it. Trust me, it's not worth it. What is the best time to arrive at the park? If you are able to make it to Carowinds before park opening, that would be ideal. Especially if your goal for the day is to get on the major good quality coasters and not have to deal with the lines that will get longer by the hour. I recommend getting to Carowinds parking tolls at least an hour before park opening. This will allow you time to spare, as there's always a decently long line of cars waiting to go through the parking tolls. You'll also have time to park your car, walk to the main gate, and wait for the park to officially open for the day. And when that happens, you might be wondering, what should I ride first? If you're trying to ride all of Carowinds' major coasters during your day, then be sure to be at the park right at opening. Do not head to Intimidator, Ferry 325, or Afterburn first. Now I know it's tempting, but resist the eye candy. I recommend getting in line for Nighthawk first, again right at park opening. Do not get in line for this Vekoma flying coaster if you're walking through the main gate 15 minutes after park opening, because the line's already going to be too long. Nighthawk has horrible capacity, so if you get in line within the first few minutes of Carowinds being open, then you're good to go. And another thing, Nighthawk and Intimidator are the two coasters that are closest to the main entrance, so most people will head there first. If you're like me and don't care for a headache, then take a ride on Copperhead Strike first, since the capacity is also pretty limited. Copperhead does offer 3 trains, but each one only holds 16 passengers. Then, I recommend heading to Ferry, Afterburn, or Intimidator, since these coasters offer a much higher capacity. Now real quick, keep in mind, if you're visiting in 2021, things might be a little bit different due to COVID and all, but you will still be able to use these tips if you're visiting this year. What's the best day to visit Carowinds? Mondays, as long as it's a non-holiday, Tuesdays, and of course Sundays. When to visit? Carowinds is usually open from late March through December, so if you're looking to experience all the park's rides and coasters, then you need to plan your trip anytime from March through October. Weekends in May and early June are the best times to go. Weekends will always be busier than weekdays. From mid-June through mid-August, the park is usually always crowded any day of the week, and when Carolina Harbor is open, this will clear the dry park out a little bit during the day, but then once the water park closes, the rides in the dry park will get longer. Pass holder early entry. Select months throughout the year, gold and platinum pass holders are able to experience a few rides before the park opens to the public. So check out Carowinds' website for more information and dates and times. Since you're watching this video to help you learn about Carowinds, I really need your help real quick in exchange. If you would, please give this video a thumbs up, because the more thumbs up the video receives, the more views it gets. And that means more people will be able to watch this video and they too can enjoy their day at Carowinds even better. Also, if you enjoy roller coasters and theme parks, then I hope you consider becoming the newest sub to my channel, and that would help me reach my goal of 10,000 subscribers by July 1st, so I thank you in advance. How many days do I need at Carowinds? If you're planning on doing both Carolina Harbor and Carowinds, then I recommend a day and a half. But if you're just here for Carowinds, then I recommend giving yourself at least 8 hours to enjoy all the park offers. Should I buy a fast lane? The rides that will have the slowest moving lines will be Nighthawk and Copperhead Strike. So if this is your first visit to Carowinds, then I would highly recommend the fast lane, depending on the day of course, just so you can experience Carowinds the best way. And that is also getting as many re-rides as you want on the park's 4 major coasters, Ferry 325, Afterburn, Intimidator, and Copperhead Strike. So if you don't like waiting in lines longer than 30 minutes, then I would definitely get a fast lane. Even though Carowinds offers 14 different coasters, only the 4 I just mentioned are top-notch. The rest are pretty bad quality. If you want to know how I rank each coaster at Carowinds, click the card on your screen for my Carowinds coaster ranking video, or check out the link in this video's description. What rides should I ride at night? My top three recommendations: Copperhead, Afterburn, and of course Fury 325. All three of these coasters are legit at night. What to wear at Carowinds? Carowinds isn't that large of a park, and it also offers a nice layout that makes getting around pretty easy. So I highly recommend wearing some awesome Theme Park Predictions merch when you visit. And you can enjoy free shipping on everything with this promo code. Check out my store at ThemeParkPredictions.com. You should always wear comfortable shoes, sunscreen, sunglasses, and light clothing. Remember, this is a Cedar Fair park, and that means there isn't much shade to enjoy while waiting in line here. And that's another great reason to purchase a fast lane. Trust me, on busy days, it's worth it, because it gets extremely hot at Carowinds. You can always leave a hoodie in a locker or in your car in case you get cold. For the men out there, I highly recommend shorts with zipper pockets. You will not find me at a park without them. Where to stay? I've heard amazing things about the new Spring Hill Suites by Marriott that's located right on Carowinds property. This makes getting to and from the park the easiest because you can just walk. Also, Carowinds offers a great campground called Camp Wilderness, and you can rent cabins, bring a tent, or if you have one, even your RV. This is a beautiful, well-kept facility. Best places to eat at Carowinds. Here are my top 5 places to eat while at the park. Number 5, Harmony Hall. A nice variety, I highly recommend the brisket sandwich. Number 4, Chickie and Pete's Sports Grill. You'll find some great Philly cheesesteaks with the best fries at Carowinds. Number 3, Harbor House, located in the Carolina Harbor, and they offer delicious fried shrimp as well as other great things. Number 2, Burrito Cafe. Who doesn't like this? And number 1, Blue Ridge Country Kitchen. Hands down, the best food in the park. And when you order food here, be sure to ask for the Copperhead sauce with your meal, because it's a delicious barbecue sauce that is highly, highly recommended. Carowinds with kids. Camp Snoopy is one of the better overall kid areas within a Cedar Fair park. Kids of all ages will have a ton of things to do no matter their height. Plus, Carowinds offers some great rides and attractions for all ages located throughout the park. Fall festivities. During the day, Carowinds is filled with awesome activities for the kids. And then at night, Carowinds turns into Scarowinds. This separate ticketed event offers a handful of haunted houses and scare zones. It does get really busy, so again, I highly recommend buying the Fright Lane Pass so you can skip the lines to the haunted houses. Is Winterfest worth it? Carowinds really goes all out for Winterfest. This event, as far as the Christmas lights go, is just as good as any other park out there. The whole park looks amazing, and the entertainment is also great. So if you're in town, then I definitely recommend checking out Winterfest. Is Carolina Harbor worth it? Overall, Carolina Harbor is a nice and clean water park. While I don't think their slide collection is top-notch, it still offers a way to cool off from the Carolina heat. Speaking of the Carolina heat, how to cool off at Carowinds? Well, you really can't, since the dry park offers zero water attractions. Zero! So if you're here in the summer, then you're kind of out of luck, and you might have to consider Carolina Harbor for a few hours. Where to go to the bathroom? Sometimes, your stomach isn't on your schedule, but don't worry, because I know the best places in Carowinds to go, you know, number 2. And those would be the newest restrooms that are located right next to Harmony Hall, because they offer plenty of toilets and the best AC in the park. And if you're over near Fury, then the restrooms across from the entrance is another great option. Best places for beer. Inside Harmony Hall, there's a great little bar that offers TVs, great drinks, and is the perfect way to take a break from the heat. Be sure to download the Carowinds app. Using the app, you can check out wait times, view the park map, and much more. Top 5 flat rides at Carowinds. Number 5, Screamweaver. Before we know it, these rides will all be defunct, so go take a ride on this classic. Number 4, Windseeker. Get a great view of the whole park 300 feet below you. Number 3, Drop Tower. Don't let the size of this tower fool you. This ride is super intense and do not miss it. Number 2, Electro Spin. An awesome ride that is pretty unique here in America. And number 1, Mountain Gliders. Because you can snap these scooters and make it a wild ride if you wanted to. Carowinds road trip advice. Get here at park opening, stay until 6 p.m, then start your drive to the next park. And if you're traveling north, then leave before 4 p.m. or after 6 p.m. because on weekdays, Charlotte traffic really does suck. Parking tips. Park as close as you can to Fury and remember your row number. Stand on the state line. Take a selfie while you're standing in two states at the same time. And I recommend doing this in front of the North and South Carolina sign, which is located right in front of the plaza stage. Where to ride? Hurler, front two rows for the smoothest ride. If you're feeling brave, then ride the back row. Nighthawk, front row, hands down for the smoothest ride. Copperhead Strike, I love both, front and back, because they both offer great hang time and air time. Afterburn. Front for the visuals, but back for the intensity. You'll find me in the back row pretty much every time I ride Afterburn. Intimidator. The front, you'll get the best airtime, but sadly, this hyper crawls through its layout. For the best riding experience, I recommend the back car. Fury 325. You have to ride Fury a few times. The front for the sheer speed and the visuals. Trust me, the extra wait time for that front row is worth it. The back for the best ride experience because you get pulled through the whole entire layout. And I cannot recommend enough sitting in the back left seat because it's the best. Basically the seat closest to the exit platform. And speaking of Fury, I want to take a second to give a shout out to the Fury crew because they are quick and efficient. And I have a background in ride operations. And let me tell you, I have not seen a faster crew since the Beast crew of 2004. And yes, that was a crew I was on. And we were legit. So to all the Fury crew members watching this, keep up the great work. As well as any other Carowinds associate out there. So those are my recommendations and tips on having the best day at Carowinds. I really hope these help you plan for a day at one of the best parks in the world. And if you have any other questions about Carowinds, feel free to reach out to me in the comments and I'd be happy to answer any questions. Also, if you think of any other great tips, then leave them in the comments as well. As always, thank you so much for watching, stay positive, be happy, and keep riding coasters.